Guys, sorry we're late. I was putting out fires. You see that thing this morning?
No.
Seems the world is pissed because our qubits work and theirs don't. So one of our competitors planted a New York Times story suggesting we get government oversight, which was nice. Anyway, we're here. We have 15 minutes, and you have some cool stuff to show us.
We hope.
We all hope. Hit us.
Okay, Jen. So, this is iteration 89 of the nematode simulation. 302 neurons mapped. Nurture data tracked from moment of first cell division.
Beautiful.
Okay, synchronize.
Synchronizing. In 3, 2, 1, go.
Overlay, please.
Here comes overlay.
Whoa.
That's impressive.
Thank you.
And at this moment, there's no sensor-based connection between the nematode and the simulation?
Nothing at all from this point of synchronization. This is movement initiated by the map neurons and the nurture data, that's all.
In which case, you can demonstrate that with a future projection?
Absolutely.
10 seconds.
Yes. Jen?
Predicted movement loop, 10 seconds into the future. So that's 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
So right in front of my eyes, you just predicted the exact behavior of a living organism, 10 seconds into the future.
The simplest organism we could find, but yes, we did.
I love it.
Okay, and so about 30 seconds from the moment we synchronize, we start to lose correlation.
30 seconds.
Thereabouts.
Why do you think that is?
Sheer complexity. The numbers we're crunching go insane. As in, truly insane.
Or?
It's a quantum type problem. Somewhere in the multiverse, there's a world where the two stay in sync. But it's not this one.
Not a fan of the multiverse theory. I'd go with the former. Guys, can you give us a moment? Sergei, you've done fantastic work. Exceptional work. But I think your time in the AI division has run its course. I want you to join devs.
Devs?
Yeah.
Thank you.